Good afternoon, family, and welcome back to Doing Life with Pastor Donovan and Chantel.
Hi, family, and welcome back to Doing Life with Pastor Donovan and Pastor Chantel.
So today, sweetheart, we want to talk about the fact that we are doing a marriage seminar on the 21st of October at the church, and we just want to, first of all, invite anybody that wants to join us. This is not exclusive to our church members. It's an external course that we're running. And we find this very helpful for people that not only are in marriages, but preparing to get married, or even those perhaps that's in the dating game.
Yeah.
Just to, you know, some tools that we want to share with you in order to enhance relationships, really.
That's right. And it's all about giving people, like we say, it's giving people the tools. It's giving you the tools, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's like always like taking care of your car.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you maintain your car.
Mm-hmm.
And so you need to have the right tools to do maintenance on your car, or to change a wheel, or and to change oil and all those things. So we're just giving people tools to apply in their marriages to help enhance their marriage. So it doesn't, don't think you just do counseling, or you go to marriage courses if there's a problem. No, you always have to put in your marriage, especially in today's world. Now, in today's world, there's such a lot of things going on in the world, and we need more than ever, we need to look after and protect our marriages.
Yeah, and you know, after or over the last, I don't know what it is, 15 years in ministry, we found that, you know, most of our counseling as pastors has been in the area of relationships.
That's
and
right.
Marriages.
Yes.
And we've developed this material over the last 15 years.
That's
and,
right.
And put tools together that really we feel has been and is helpful to people to enhance their marriages, to create you know, really opportunities for people to grow and to understand, you know, what it is that their partners and their marriages, you know, need in today's world. And it's obviously all based on God's word.
That's
it's
right.
Obviously all Christian based.
Yes.
And but there are practical tools that we want to put in your hands.
That's right.
That you can apply, that you can go and institute or implement in your marriage. That's the right word. Implement in your marriage.
Yes.
That will help you to grow and better understand your partner.
Yeah, and especially if you are in the process of getting married, or you're thinking of getting married, this is so important. We find it so helpful for couples just to lay a foundation, you know, before they enter into marriage. Yes, you will do premarital counseling with your pastors or whichever church you belong to, but this is just that extra toolbox.
Yeah.
We call it the toolbox that we give you to know that if there's challenges, you have a toolbox. You will take out the right tool to apply when. And because it needs to become a lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
There's not just something that you pull out when you have a problem. No, it's a lifestyle that you enter in. If you talk about love languages, you're not just going to apply it one day in your marriage. No, you need to apply it right through your marriage.
Absolutely, and I find that a lot of the things that we cover, you know, there might be things that you've heard about.
Yeah.
You used an example. We discuss love languages, but more than just understanding or knowing about love languages, is how does it practically work in a relationship?
That's right.
How do you implement some of those things? We cover subjects and things like, for example, the social covenant.
That's
or
right.
Couples covenant.
Yes.
Again, it's a tool that we find very helpful.
Mm.
We speak about things like emotional bank accounts
and
how that again works in the marriage, in the relationship. How do you apply these things?
That's right.
Because we find that a lot of people know about a lot of stuff, but knowing about it and doing it are two different things. And so this course is designed to really get you to implement some stuff in your marriage. You walk away from this course and you have got what you've called, and rightly so, a toolbox that can help you navigate around different challenges.
Mm.
Because the truth of the matter is, when you are in a relationship, when you are in a marriage, challenges do
That's
come.
Right.
You know, it's two different individuals with two different personalities, two different viewpoints and opinions about different things
that
are trying to make this life together.
Yeah.
And so we understand that within marriage, you know, there is a covenant that you enter into, and that covenant is threefold.
That's
it is between you, your husband, wife,
and God. Yes.
And so we look from that perspective,
yes,
and to see, you know, how important is this covenant,
mm,
and how you need to protect it,
yes,
by making sure that there's always different tools that you are able to go to your toolbox to and to find the right tools to address certain problems.
Yeah. And you know, we talk about communication. We talk about soul ties and the importance of covenant, importance of God in your marriage, and how to communicate effectively,
mm,
to each other, because we find so many people don't know how to communicate.
Mm.
And even though they have been married for years, they still don't know how to communicate,
mm,
with each other.
Mm.
And in today's world, it is so important that we,
absolutely,
know how to communicate with our partners, with our spouse, because no, there's such a lot of misunderstanding so easily,
mm,
get into your marriage and you don't know how to deal with it.
And it's not communication as in talking.
That's right.
You know, that is just a small part of communication.
Mm.
But when we speak about communication,
yeah,
you know, it's effective communication.
Yes.
How do you speak to your husband, to your wife,
mm,
your partner? How do you speak to them in a way that really appeals to them? You know, we're all different.
Yes.
One of the things that we discuss is the difference between men and women and how we think differently.
Mm.
How God has designed us and made us,
that's right,
to think differently.
Mm.
And so when we enter into a marriage, when we enter into a relationship, we need to understand that God has given us certain tools that we are able to navigate,
yeah,
through the storms of,
yeah,
life. And yes, God is the center of all,
yeah,
marriages. In fact, you know, if God is not the center of marriages, you get to find it very difficult to be able to navigate through different,
mm-hmm,
situations. Because at the end of the day, there has to be an authority, there has to be an accountability,
that's right,
that we have in our lives.
That's right.
And as Christians, that is God.
Yeah.
God is the final authority.
That's,
he's the,
right,
the Word is our final authority.
Yes.
And so it doesn't matter really what our opinions,
yes,
are. We need to stick to what,
yeah,
the Word says.
And you know, people, we all come from different backgrounds. We raised differently.
Mm.
We see things in our households with our mom and dads and how they did marriage, and we think that is the right way.
Yeah.
But perhaps it's not. And you think you can apply what you've saw in your childhood, how your mom and dad was, you think you can apply that into your marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Not knowing that, or not realizing, we have different backgrounds,
mm-hmm,
we have different experiences. And so all those factors,
mm-hmm,
play a role.
Absolutely.
in your marriage, in your covenant. And especially if we're born again, we do marriages differently,
mm-hmm,
than the world does.
Mm-hmm. And you know, there is no cookie-cut marriage. You know, it's not the way we are doing marriage is going to necessarily,
yes,
work for you. And so the tools that we put in your hands during this course is really, it's really meant to help in any situation.
Mm.
It does not mean your marriage must
look
like mine,
mm,
that you have to behave in,
yes,
a certain way. It does not,
yeah,
mean that, or it does not mean that you have to walk around,
mm,
quoting scriptures every day,
that's
in your,
right,
home. You know, because as we go through this different marriage counseling steps, and marriage counseling, I use that term loosely,
mm-hmm,
because like we said, it's not trying to fix anybody.
Mm-hmm.
But when we go through these different steps, we want to make sure that each and every person can apply it.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's not to say that your marriage needs to look like anybody else.
Right.
Your marriage needs to be adapted to how you and your husband and wife, how it's going to suit you, how,
yeah,
it's going to work for you,
yeah,
in your marriage.
And how it's going to enhance your marriage. Because ultimately, we all want to make our marriages better. You know,
mm,
we want to impart in each other so that we can become better people,
mm,
on the end of the day. And if we have happy homes,
mm,
you know, that filters down to our kids.
Mm. Mm.
And so we just, if you know that, like we said in the beginning, doesn't mean that your marriage is falling apart, that you need this, even if you just want to enhance your marriage.
Yeah.
You can have a stable home and still come to this course and,
mm-hmm,
to just enhance your marriage.
Absolutely.
Make it a better covenant.
Mm-hmm. You know, I love the way we start with the course. You know, we start off with a questionnaire just to understand a little bit how people have got different struggles that they, you know, some people struggle in the area of finances within the marriage and budgeting as a couple.
Yes.
Yeah, perhaps they've been single for a long time and now all of a sudden they have to budget together. In-laws, what is the role that in-laws play?
Right.
You know, do they have a role? Do they have a say in your marriage?
Right.
Do they have a say in the discipline of your children? Mm. We talk about those things and again, you know, these are real problems that people sit with.
Facing.
You mentioned it earlier on, you know, when you're talking about, for example, interracial marriages, there are things like cultural differences. You know, that how does that impact? And I think the important thing is that we need to talk about these things before we even step into marriage a lot of times, because we find so many people enter into marriages with a lot of baggage, really, that they haven't discussed or disclosed even with their partners, and that tends to become a problem during marriages. And so we want to talk about those things. So that questionnaire is designed to open up some form of discussion. You know, what are the things that you battle with? What are the things that you foresee could be a problem going forward?
Yes,
and so we start over that marital questionnaire, and let's have a discussion around that.
That's right.
And we facilitate talks around it. You know, we are very proud of this this marriage course that we've put together, and we've run it successfully for a number of years. And we know that it will strengthen and benefit you.
Because we've seen the benefits. You know, we've seen the benefits in our life, how we implement these tools. We don't just talk about it, we implement it. And if there's tools that perhaps that we lack in, with this course it always reminds us that it's time to implement these things and to constantly be aware of these tools in our marriage. So it helps us as well as we walk the journey through this course, the couple of hours with the couples or with, you don't even have to be a couple. If you if you're single and you want to do it with a friend, come join. You know, it's for you because it's going to benefit you on the end of the day as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. And so this course is running on the 21st of October. That is in just over 2 weeks' time. And it's going to be on a Saturday afternoon from 1 o'clock in the afternoon till 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
Yes.
So it's a half-day seminar. There is a cost for the manual, and then we're also intending to provide a little snack, just like a tea break or something to that effect. And so therefore, the course, we've costed it at 100 rand. It's really just to cover expenses of the manual, etc. And because Pastor Chantal and I, we are very passionate about marriages. We want to see marriages succeed. We want to see relationships go to a new level. We know that God has instituted marriage, and we want to impart into you.
Yes.
So how do you get to get onto this course? You say, Pastor, we're not in your church. Can we come?
Yes.
And the answer is yes. It's open to anybody.
Yes.
We need to know, obviously, for catering purpose and for the manual printing, we need to know how many people we can expect. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to invite you to get in contact with either Pastor Chantal or myself, and we will put our cell phone numbers on the screen so that you can contact us, phone us, and message us, and so that will give us an idea of how many people to cater for. We don't want the class to be too big because we want it to be interactive, and so we do want to manage the size of the class as well. So if you and your partner, and even if you want to come alone, and you know, please let us know as soon as possible so that we can then cater accordingly. But it's going to be a great time. I'm super excited about this course because, like I said, it's close to our hearts.
Yeah.
And you know, as pastors, we might not be your pastors, but as pastors, we've got a heart for people. We've got a heart for relationships and marriages, and we want to help where we can.
That's right.
So we want to sincerely invite you to come along and
spend the afternoon
with us. Yeah,
that's
absolutely.
Right. So it's going to be venue, it will be at our church, but we will put all the details at the bottom of this video. And so we're looking forward to having you to spend the afternoon with you and learn from you as well. You know, because perhaps you have something in what you do in your marriage that we can learn from, and perhaps, you know, look at it and see how it can benefit the rest of the class.
All right, so thank you so much for just giving us your attention for the last couple of minutes. We truly trust and hope that we will see some of you at the course, and we know that it's going to richly enrich mm-hmm. your relationships and your marriages.
Well, family, from our home to your home, we love you and we continue praying for you.
Thank you once again for joining us, and we will see you soon. God bless.